The business news is brought to you by ElitePOS Zambia. ElitePOS, your complete point of sale, software and hardware supply.
The Zambian government has made positive efforts in ensuring that it implements the outcome of the 34th Southern Africa Development Committee Council of Energy Ministers Summit that was held in 2015. Following the meeting, SADC member states were requested to provide necessary policies on energy efficiency aimed at helping the region manage itself. Among measures that were taken include the ban of the use of incandescent bulbs, which Zambia implemented in 2016 through statutory instrument number 74. Golden Yalinga now reports.
Incandescent bulbs are energy-efficient lighting devices that have been discouraged among SADC member countries since 2015. Zambia implemented the ban in 2016 after signing a statutory instrument number 74, which put an end to the manufacturing and selling of such bulbs. According to the Minister of Commerce, Trade and Industry, the country would be saving about 200 megawatts as a result of the ban. I recently engaged some hardware dealers operating in the central business district of Lusaka to ascertain the prevailing situation.
The ordinary bulbs, I don't like them, but others, they still buy them. They say like that they last longer than the NH7 bulbs. But NH7 bulbs, I love
bulb. Then when I'm ordinary bulb, mama gula, kutiwa fake machani yankuku ma incubators yankuku.
So those who are still selling those ordinary bulbs, I would advise them to start selling energy savers and like those old ones.
In response to the continued illegal manufacturing and sale of incandescent bulbs, the Energy Regulation Board partnered with the Zambia Bureau of Standards to come up with technical standards on lighting devices that provide a requirement for manufacturers to obtain licenses. The regulator observed that since 2016, when SI-74 was implemented, there has been an increased prevalence in the use of light bulbs, which are branded energy savers, when in fact are not. Fred Hangandu is ERB Senior Manager, Consumer and Public Affairs.
The ERB, in collaboration with the Zambia Bureau of Standards, has completed the development of technical standards on solar water heaters, which will be published in the Government Gazette before the end of 2018. The SADC Council of Energy Ministers Summit approved the establishment of the SADC Center for Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency, SACRI. One of the immediate tasks of SACRI is to harmonize the switching from inefficient light bulbs such as incandescent bulbs to efficient ones like CFLs.
The technical standards on lighting devices shows exemption on lighting devices that are not energy efficient, such as infrared for medical purposes, automobile lightings for experimental purposes with accepted efficacy. The concept of energy saving bulbs is critical for lesser sources of energy such as solar, wind, coal and biogas. I spoke to the Rural Electrification Authority Chief Executive Officer, Godfrey Msonda.
The mandate of the Rural Electrification Authority is to provide electricity infrastructure in rural areas of this country. We do this by utilizing different types of technologies, some of them, of course, being grid extension, solar home systems, mini grids. And, of course, we utilize renewable energy, particularly solar, small hydro, and now we have also gone wind.
Matthew Nkua is energy minister and shares government position.
What the government is trying to do is to discourage the use of those bulbs. I would give you an example. I keep some day-old chicks at my home, and I need the incandescent bulbs, you know, for heating up. So you can't completely ban. They'll be required for other special uses and things like that. So we are trying to discourage so that people can go into a cost saving and also encourage them, because this cost saving, you know, if they save the power, for example, if you've got a house and you use the right bulbs, you save power and you only use 40% of the power that you are supposed to use.
For 5FM News, I'm Goden Yalenga.
That ends business news.